And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. We are, well, we're getting somewhere, I can tell you that much. Let's head for these biotopes. Now that we have a micro generator. Let's go to this one first. The first one we found was the canyon one. Okay. Sounds spooky. What does this thing look like again? Ah, it fits right in there. Cool. Click.
This is a topographical map of the biotope. The main habitats are the caverns, the pit, and the crater.
Okay. So we're going to send these little things to investigate, I guess, to see if there's any more animals that don't belong here. Someone's trying to smuggle them in. It's just, it can't be coincidence that they just all accidentally end up here.
This is a topographical map.
Look at the eyes are going insane. Oh, I didn't want to move off. I just wanted to move them.
This micro generator is completely drained. Yet the charge should have lasted several days under these conditions.
I was right. We are going to have to walk back and forth every time.
This terminal is offline.
Damn it. Now I gotta go back and recharge that thing every time? That's insane. Yeah, it's annoying. Got all the way back to the shuttle bay for that. Okay. I want Worf to move. I want to get a look at what's going on here. Don't walk off. This thing spirals around. Okay, I have data. Use it. Not on Crusher. Worf's still in the way.
This is a topic.
Worf. See, this thing goes freaking crazy. Alright. Let's say look at Field Unit B. Alright, that was over there.
This is a topographical map of the biotope.
This is a topographical.
This is a topographical map of the.
They're all saying the exact same thing.
This is a topograph.
Alright, so.
I do not believe that will work.
We got to. I think we're supposed to use these on this.
I see no way of using this with that object. I see no way of.
What are we supposed to do? On an antenna? Oh, I didn't see the antenna.
This antenna must be part of the preserve's monitoring system.
Huh.
I believe this is part of the preserve's surveillance system.
Indeed.
That surveillance system must help the watchers keep an eye on the biotopes.
This is part of the surveillance system monitoring distress calls in the preserve. The antennae trigger informational displays of various species.
Hmm. Can I use this on an antenna?
I see no way of you.
Okay. Can I use this on something like a pit? Okay, cool. So it's gonna go get data for us. No pun intended.
The field unit is stalled. It is not configured for this biotope.
Please don't let this thing die. Okay, let's use A. Do we have to configure it? Or is it automatically configured already? Try unit A. Look at that, it has a little grabby thing on the bottom and a sticky thing there. Sounds like people yelling in the background. Oh, it's so slow. What now? Did you get your information? It's so slow. Why the game make us wait this long like this? Well, he didn't say it stalled out, so I guess it checked it out. And it's gonna tell us something. Didn't say anything. Oh, we got it. Do we look at it now? What do we do?
The field unit is configured for a specific The field unit
Well... Wait.
This Class A field unit is configured for rocky terrain and torrid climate zones.
Okay. So... I guess it didn't find anything?
The field unit is configured for a specific terrain...
It monitors the condition.
We would need several days to completely search this area ourselves. The field units could accomplish the task in far less time.
Okay, well, I'm gonna guess it didn't find anything, then. Alright, so it's field unit... Oh, rocky field unit. We already found it. Rocky field unit. Didn't find anything, rocky field unit. Okay, let's... On the pit... Wait... On the caverns. I'm guessing, guys, it didn't find anything. I don't know how else to see what it found.
That is unnecessary.
Caverns, pit, crater. Would I send it to the pit or the crater? I'm not even sure. Damn it. Wait. Pit. Nothing?
The field unit is
Pit. Where's that crater? This is so boring waiting for this thing to go there and back, and I don't even know if I'm doing it the right thing.
This Class A field unit. I see no way of...
What do we do? Oh, what do we have? What is this? Sunil sample? Umblumba sample? What the hell is this stuff?
This sample indicates a vegetarian diet, but the ID tag identifies the Sunil rodent as a carnivore. Additional lab work would be advisable.
Huh.
The neural cells of this deceased Umblumba bird exhibit unusual readings. Additional lab work would be advisable.
Okay. That was just on a lock. I decided to use this thing on this.
We would need several days to completely...
I know that.
There is no sample in this field unit.
Okay.
If there were,
cool.
We could extract it with a bioprobe.
Good, so we've got samples from the thing. That's awesome. Genser sample.
Although it is tagged as a Genser lizard, its blood samples contradict the identification. Additional lab work would be advisable.
Hmm.
Although it's tagged as a Genser, the neural cells of this deceased...
They all say the same thing in this case.
According to the sample, the DNA signature of this creature does not match its ID tag.
Okay, well, Worf says something else.
It is a sample from a dead Umblumba bird. There are unusual neuro readings. According to its tag, the Sunil is a carnivorous rodent. Yet this sample indicates a vegetarian diet.
This sample was taken in the canyons, but the creature it's from lives only in the grasslands.
Oh, interesting.
This is a sample from a dead Umblumba.
It's
showing abnormal neural readings. There's something wrong with this sample. The creature's tagged as a carnivore, but those readings indicate a vegetarian diet.
Mm-hmm.
This sample indicates a healthy vegetarian diet, but the ID tag indicates the Sunil rodent is a carnivore.
All right. Cool, let's get our generator and our rocky field unit. And if I analyze these units with the tricorder, will it tell us what they do?
This Class C field unit is configured for aquatic travel.
Cool, so that's the aquatic travel one, and now we know it is that.
Field units are built to suit different...
Alright, let's check out the other one.
The Class B field unit is configured for mountainous terrain and...
Cool. So I cut her off there. Alright, let's go to the other areas. We have 9 of these freaking things, probably. Okay, there's going to be a lot of editing of this stuff and save you guys the problem of having to wait. Oh, crap! No, I have to charge the thing. Oh, damn it. I came here for nothing. Greetings. Okay.
This is a topographical map of the biotope. The main habitats are the 4 tunnels within that petrified tree.
Everything lives in those tunnels? Can't look at this stuff that flies by. Alright, we want the tropical field unit. And I think we just send it off to Tunnel 1. Okay. So this one's going to have 4 of them. I'm just going to go ahead and send it to all, you know, the other 3 tunnels.
It's not working.
Oh, because we have to use it. Which ends up us taking it. Okay. Alright, I got a hard time, or at least I had a hard time finding that 4th tunnel. Pixel hunting.
This field unit's empty.
Okay. Okay, so these ones are green.
The neural cells of this deceased direwood ferret show unusual readings. Additional lab work may be advisable. The neural cells of this deceased Granger bogfish show unusual readings.
Granger bogfish.
The neural cells of this deceased Comte shrew show unusual readings. The blood sample from this Nero Wolf contradicts its ID tag.
Nero Wolf. Anyone else have anything to say?
This sample shows unusual neural readings.
We'll never be able to cover that much area ourselves, but the field units are programmed for it, and they're much faster.
You're supposed to tell us about the Granger sample, Worf.
According to the identification tag, this sample was taken from a Granger bogfish. However, its neural readings are quite unusual.
We're full of creatures that don't belong here.
This sample is from a Compt shrew. The cause of death appears to be severe neural damage.
So whatever causes neural damage around here, well, causes it around here.
This blood sample was taken from a Nero Wolf, but these readings are not consistent with that species.
Hmm. They might have spelled that wrong, too.
This sample was taken from a creature with some unusual neural readings. This sample is from a Granger's bogfish. Apparently, it suffered some kind of neural drain. This sample is from a Compt shrew. It shows decreased neuroelectric activity. This sample came from a Nero wolf, according to the ID tag. Hmm. But that's not consistent with these readings.
Right.
The neural cells of this deceased direwood ferret show unusual readings.
He just says unusual readings like Crusher does.
The blood sample from this Nero Wolf contradicts its ID tag.
Okay. Let's get the thing back. Now we get ahead for the marine biome, biotope. Which is that way. Gotta say, really I'm enjoying the game up till now. This is really drudgery. Let me just save so I don't lose all this progress I've made. Episode 9. Oh, we didn't charge that thing! Oh. I don't suppose it'll work. Let me just try it. Oh, I left it in the other thing. Damn it. I gotta go back and retrieve it and then go back to the shuttle and, yeah, charge it. I hope you guys appreciate all the editing I'm doing, because I am bored stiff. Waiting for them to walk everywhere. It's driving me insane.
This is a topographical map of the biotope. The main habitats are within the jelly corals and the water.
Only two? Or each jelly coral? Yeah. That's a difference there. Rocky. Aquatic field. On all jelly corals. Okay. Go. What's the rest? The water? Hold on, what do you say?
This is a topographical.
And the water. Alright. Where in the water? Edlin sample? Let's see if we get another sample from a different coral fish or whatever the hell it is.
This sample was taken from a creature with some unusual neural readings.
Am I right? The other one? Yeah. This is the new one.
The blood sample from this Edlin fish contradicts its ID tag. Additional lab work would be advisable.
The blood sample from this Edlin fish can't...
According to the sample, the DNA signature of this creature does not match its ID tag.
Okay, let's analyze a different one. This one. So I can't get to water. I don't know, it might be one separate pixel. That's insane. We got a different sample, didn't we? Grath sample.
All readings are normal.
This sample was taken from a creature with some unusual neural readings.
Then why did he say everything was normal?
All readings are normal.
Huh. Which is it?
The sample of the Grath eel shows a slightly elevated white blood count. But all other readings are normal.
Hmm.
The blood sample of the Grath eel shows a slight...
Alright. A new one. Cortex sample. So I guess we'll collect four more. We've done these two. Got one, two, three, four left.
The epidermal sample shows that the cortic arthropod is shedding, but all other readings are normal.
The epidermal sample shows the cortic arthropod is shedding.
All readings are normal.
This sample was taken from a creature with some unusual neural readings.
Why does it have unusual neural readings?
The epidermal sample should...
It's shedding. It doesn't have unusual neural readings. So I'm going to collect, you know, the other four and see what we come up with. Oh wait, these are not selectable. Wait. Jelly corals. These are too far away then. Alright. Well, I did use it on that. These are too far away. Alright, one more. Berkby sample.
The blood sample shows the Berkby fish is undergoing its seasonal transformation. All other readings are normal.
The blood sample shows the Berkby fish is undergoing its seasonal transformation.
All readings are normal.
This sample was taken from a creature with some unusual neural readings.
I think Troy failed class with this subject. So how do I analyze this stuff? I put it here?
I can't use this with that.
Let's get the dead animal off. Maybe we use it with that? I don't know what we do with what.
Seriodiagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. All readings are normal.
Okay, so these are the ones that were fine from the marine area.
Seriodiagnostic
Oh, it's deleting them when we do it? Oh.
Serio diagnostic. Serio diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. Subject's genetic signature differs from its identification tag.
Right.
Serio diagnostic.
Same identification tag.
Serial diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. Subject's neural pathways have been drained of electrical energy.
Doesn't sound pleasant.
Serial diagnostic.
Same. Drained of electrical energy.
Serial diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. Subject contains high ionic residue and trace amounts of neural tranquilizers. Originating creature may consume energy.
Alright, then we gotta look at what we're using. Dire wolf? Dire woods? Dire wood, right? It consumes energy? Okay, let's try this Genser sample.
Serial diagnostic
differs. Sunil sample? Drained of energy, and Umblumba sample.
Serial diagnostic test.
Drained. Drained. All right. Anything to say now?
It may be useful to share our findings with Healer Zolas.
Healer Zolas. Well, we could talk to Worf, but Crusher, we gotta walk over there.
I'd like to talk to Healer Zolas.
Healer Zolas may help interpret our findings.
I get the feeling you guys want to talk to Healer Zolas.
I'd like to contact Healer Zolas.
Okay, it seems to be unanimous then. Let's use our tricorder on this thing. Let's just check on the others. Grower.
Open a channel to Grower Inongo.
Channels to grow.
Tiller?
Open a channel to.
Channels to.
Tracker, why not?
Open a channel to Tracker Melas.
Channels open.
Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
Why, thank you.
Open a channel to Consultant Idia.
He's so pleasurable to talk to.
Channels open.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you for wasting it.
What were the questions we wanted to ask? Let me just look. We'll waste it again.
Open the channel.
Channels.
I wish to ask you some questions.
Look, I'm in the middle of some very delicate research. Can't you find someone else to bother?
You look delighted when you talk to us, though. Oh, that's it. Okay. Let's talk to Healer Zolas.
Open a channel to Healer Zolas.
Channels open.